Hello, we are going to mention elliptic curves in adverse form, or shortly adverse curves. Addition law on elliptic curves is mainly based on constructing new points from known points. We use chords and tangents for construction for common curves such as Weierstrass or Koblitz, but this is different in adverse curves. Consider the unit circle. X squared plus y squared is equal to 1. Here p1 is a point on the unit circle and its coordinates are x1, y1. This means that this distance is equal to x1 and this one is equal to y1. Suppose that the angle between y coordinate and p1 is equal to alpha. In this case, y1 becomes cosine alpha, whereas x1 becomes sine alpha. And we can express the coordinates of p1 as sine alpha, cos alpha instead of x1, y1. Similarly, p2 is another point on the curve. And suppose that the angle between y coordinate and p2 is equal to beta. And in this case, coordinates of P2 can be written as sine beta and cosine beta instead of x2 and y2. P1 and P2 are known points, and we will find the point that having an angle between y coordinate alpha plus beta. Here, remember the angle sum identities. And x3, which is the x coordinate of the new point p3, x3, which is also equal to sine alpha plus beta, can be expressed as this value, and y3, which is also equal to cosine alpha plus beta, can be expressed as this value based on the angle sum identities rules. And we can transform them with these terms. We can construct a new point p3 from these known points p1 and p2 on the unit circle, but this is not elliptic, and this causes this to be weak against some cryptographic attacks. Here, adverse curve is an elliptic alternative of the unit circle, and its equation is very similar to unit circle. We just append the d times x squared y squared. Here, d is a constant value. For example, here d is equal to minus 50. Suppose that p1 and p2 are points on the adverse curve, and we can construct a new point p3 on this adverse curve from known points p1 and p2. How? Edwards addition law states that new point can be found by this pretty formula. Notice that its numerators are same with the unit circles formulas, but differently. They have denominators. This addition formula is first discovered by Euler in 1761, and this is the name of the book. It's not in English, and I find this illustration from the Euler's book. But it's not fully clear that how Euler found this addition formula. It might be just based on his observations without proof. But we can still prove the correctness of this formula. We have already the adverse curve equation. If this new point is on the curve, then it must satisfy the equation. That's why I will replace I will replace the derived values instead of x3 y3. I will evaluate the powers separately, and let's make denominators are same to apply addition. When denominators are same, I can simplify the denominators, and here the numerators. Calculations becomes complex and complex. That's why I will set p to x1, x2, y1, y2 to make the calculation simpler. Focus on this term on the right side. They both have same power, so I can combine the power. Also, it can be expressed as 1 minus d squared p squared squared value. Now evaluate powers to parentheses. Estin x1, x2, y1, y2 appear again. Set p to them again. The left side includes 1 plus d squared, p squared, and d 1 plus d squared, p squared, and 2 times dp values. This is minus sign and this is plus sign. Let's separate them. One plus d squared p squared as multiplier, and 2 times dp as a multiplier. These terms will have a minus sign because they would multiply by minus 2 times dp. Estin plus 2p and minus 2p will become 0 in the parentheses. Here this term can be rewritten as multiplications. This term can be written as another multiplication too. And let's move 2 times dp into the parentheses. I mean that multiply. And in the right side, move 2p to the outside of the parentheses. Continue. Manipulations in the left side of the equation is over. Now let's time to manipulate the right side. Here, focus on the this term. This term can be rewritten as the multiplication of terms, and this term can be written as this. This is the final form of the equation. Let's focus on the 1 minus d squared p squared squared value. Actually, the left side have 1 plus d squared p squared multiplier. That's why I will form this term as, and here I will restore the p value. Adding and subtracting same values will not change the result. And I will separate plus and minus sign terms. Here, let's multiply the first parenthesis and the second parenthesis. Continue. Let's restore the p value. Let's combine the parts that containing d times x1 squared, y1 squared, and d times x2 squared and y2 squared. These terms can be written as these terms. Let's replace 1 minus d squared p squared squared value in the main equation here. It becomes much complex, I know that, but a few steps remained. Let's multiply d into the parentheses terms. As seen, left side and the right side, they both have 2 times dp times these values. We can simplify them. Also, left side has minus 8 times dp squared, and right side has minus 4 times dp squared. I will move this term to the right side and restore the p value here and separate them. Instead of 4 times dp, I will replace 2 times dp plus 2 times dp. I mean that this value is equal to 4 times dp. Let's combine the terms that containing d times x1 squared, y1 squared, and d times x2 squared, y2 squared. And these terms can be written as addition squared values. Let's combine terms that containing 1 plus d squared p squared, and now combine that containing combine terms that containing d times x1 squared y1 squared again. That's the final form. Again, that's the final form of the equation. Let's consider the original EdDSA curve equations and put x1, y1 and x2, y2 values into the main equation. Actually, squared values will be valid too. And move the term on the right side to the left side. Meanwhile, let's multiply these two equations. Finally, all terms in the blanked parentheses is equal to zero. That's why zero is equal to zero. Correctness is proven because zero is really equal to zero. So we have mentioned the normal form of elliptic curves called EdDSA curves, because it's introduced by Harold EdDSA in 2007. And this type of curves comes with the faster and secure infrastructure. Thank you for watching and see you next time.